For those that don't know much about me, possibly heard bad things. Some of you may have heard good things. We have. I've been ministering for over 34 years. I believe that Jesus Christ is Lord. He has risen from the dead. His blood cleanses and redeems us. And if it were not for him, I would be dead today. I have a fantastic testimony of how he saved me when I was in the street. I had under an overdose of heroin, a rock musician, and studied classical music. And found Christ found me, and if he had not found me, I would be completely, I wouldn't have done any of this. I'd be dead. Thank God for that. So that's in a nutshell my story. At the time when I gave up my music, I felt a strong calling to ministry. I had not been churched in any way. I had no experience in church whatsoever. And I sort of thank God I didn't, because I wouldn't be doing what I'm doing today. I had a feeling that I was going to be a minister, and I tried to go to Bible college, and they told me that I would never be a minister. And I tried second time, just after I'd become a Christian, I tried again to go and study theology. And upon being interviewed, they informed me that I would never be a good minister. So, and I thank God they did that, because I was then very rejected and sought the Lord. And I used to play songs on the piano and sing under the inspiration of the Spirit and make up songs and worship the Lord until I started singing songs, not from me to the Lord, but then God started singing songs to me from him. And so it became very interesting. It's called the Song of the Lord. I did this in my private life and had given up my music in terms of my profession as a rock musician, knowing that that's what God wanted. That developed into a gift of prophecy, which is in the Bible, and it's stated the 9 gifts of the Spirit. Now, I won't take very long, but I want, because we have so much to share with you today, but just to give you a little background for those that don't know me, that developed into prophecy, and I would go to our church and try and prophesy, and the church, the system rejected me and said that this is not scriptural, the way I was doing, because I was doing it from the piano and singing. Eventually, that grew and grew until I realized that I could be a prophet. Nobody told me that. I just would read the Bible and say, well, I'm doing what prophets did, even though we're not under law anymore. And so I pursued that in terms of prayer, and I love praying. I pray every day for a long time, twice a day, 3 times a day, actually. And this came out of it, and I started prophesying. Of course, I was under leadership in South Africa in a local church, and went and fought in a war in South Africa, went in the military while South Africa was in a war with Angola, and did military training there. And while I was there, started branching out and evangelizing. The Lord led me to the United States of America in 1981. I traveled and worked here in the smallest, the biggest of towns throughout this nation, and did that for 10 years. There were rough times. Got to know America. Got to love America. Got to understand the culture. Got to understand the religious culture in America. Got to understand the various kinds of people and the way they think. From the south, northeast, west coast. It took God practically 10 to 12 years just to train me so that I would be a prophet to this nation. I don't claim this by myself. I've paid my dues. And in the 90s, we moved here and became citizens recently. But we moved here in 91, and God started opening up and broadening my prophetic perspective and perception. It used to be at local churches over individuals, and then suddenly I started getting these visions and dreams about the future of this nation. And that's what happened. I would begin to prophesy on a larger scale about the future of America. In 1996, under a very strong anointing in Detroit, Michigan, I prophesied about a terrorist attack in New York. Very clear, it was not any Well, you saw the, you heard the audio, because that night we never had video, but the next night we did, but we had the audio. And I prophesied about a terrorist attack that I'd seen take place. And I in New York, as I saw planes flying over and attacking America, it was a moment that I'll never forget. I was caught up into that moment and prophesied as if it had already happened. When Osama bin Laden orchestrated the attacks in New York with American and United Airlines planes that flew into the Twin Towers, into Pennsylvania, and I was and all that happened at the time, I was bombarded by the news media at the time when all this happened. I was interviewed and even referred to as a modern-day Nostradamus, which to me was not a compliment, as my heart was broken because of the heartache caused by this religious maniac. In 2004, I met with President Bush. During that time, had a prophetic word regarding, first of all, his re-election in 2004. I met him face-to-face. It's many of you don't know, I was very discouraged at the time. And he said to me, never stop prophesying, and gave me a word. But during that time, I also gave him prophetic word regarding a hurricane that would take place. And I didn't say New Orleans at the time. I said that it would be during his term. During that time, I also had a prophetic word, and this is very important for you to note, a word, an insight regarding the whereabouts of Osama bin Laden. Now, a lot of you have written in and said, well, you prophesied that he would die in a cave. First of all, I never said that. I prophesied that he is laughing from the cave. And remember, this is 2004. And so he went through various locations. But I also prophesied in which manner he would die. And it's very gruesome. In that same prophecy, you will read that when he's in the cave laughing, immediately after it speaks about how he's going to die and that his intestines will come out. And he would be, and of course, I spoke about his head and the decapitation of his head, which we know he was shot in the head. Why am I telling you this so I can say I have a feather in my cap? Absolutely not. We have to know what God said about this event and what would take place after this. Prophecy is a puzzle. God only gives us pieces of the puzzle. Why? I don't know. But he gives us signs, pieces of the puzzle, so that we know it's the time, so we can pray effectively, and that we can offer hope and encouragement to our fellow brothers and our fellow men. And that's what this is all about. When people write in angry because they think I don't believe that Jesus is coming back, I totally do believe, but I don't know when. And even though the signs show that he will be coming soon, my duty is to take occupation and spread the good news of the gospel throughout the earth as best I can, and that is what I will do. Now, this word that I gave him, it was written. I wrote it out as I do. Maybe I'll show you one day, but the same thing I did with the Queen, I did that with many presidents. I write out the word. And I wrote the word, the written word, that my staff and I compiled. It was then sent to Senator John McCain, and that word was given to the president.